Welcome to a new Siemens Connected Home training video. In this video, we're going to see how we pair this device to our system. So this device is the thermostat RDZ100ZB. It's the version of the thermostat that has a relay inside. So the thermostat comes with the back plate and it comes with batteries. And the first thing you need to do is to mount this back plate on your wall. So the main topology or the main reason you want to use this device is basically to replace an old manual thermostat that you might have in your house. The topology is that you have one thermostat in your entire house that controls your boiler, and this device would then be replacing that manual thermostat that has been sitting there for the entire house for a very long time. So as I said, the first thing you need to do is to fix that backplate on your wall. And basically what you can do is take your mobile application, and you see here that I have already a radiator in my living room. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be putting this thermostat in my kitchen. So I press the little plus button, add a device, and you see that I have a few devices that I can pick from. I'm gonna take the RDZ100. So what does it say? It says press standby button for 5 seconds to begin the joining network. So one thing I need to show you first is that for this device here, you have a little hole, okay? And that little hole is used to basically come with your screwdriver and lift the front plate. So if I go like this and I basically put my screwdriver, you see that the front plate lifts and I have access here to the battery compartment. So I'm gonna be putting the batteries in. You see that the device lights up, and I'm gonna be then putting the device on the wall. I have a little screw here to basically fix the device on the wall. There we go. And I can put the back plate on, the front plate on. So you have this standby button here, and it told me in the app that I need to press that standby button for 5 seconds. So that's what I'm gonna be doing. And you see here the pairing sign that is blinking, meaning that this device is now in pairing mode. So in the app, I say that I've been pressing that standby button for 5 seconds. And when I say pressed, basically it triggers here on the hub, the pairing process of the hub as well. And you see that that Zigbee LED is now blinking. Okay, so I need to wait a few seconds. And now you saw that this pairing icon has stopped blinking and is now steadily lighted up, meaning that the device has paired. And you can see that it was super fast. And so now I have my device on the wall, linked already. And I need to take my mobile application, and I can give a name to this device. So I'm just gonna call it thermostat, and I can select in which room I want it to be. So I want it to be in the kitchen. Save. And that's it basically. So now you have that in the living room, I had that radiator and a thermostat. And in that kitchen, we have this new thermostat that I just put. One small thing I want to add is, for whatever reason, if you need to do a factory reset to change the thermostat to another room or to another house, it's very simple. Basically, what you need to do is to press the plus and the minus button for approximately 10 seconds. So that's what I'm currently doing. And basically, you have the device that is restarting. And now you don't have that linking icon anymore because the device has done this factory reset. And you see that in the app, the device is now offline because I did that factory reset. It's not linked to the hub anymore. So again, if you want to use this thermostat in another house, for instance, link it to another hub, then better do a factory reset for the device to be in full factory mode. Thanks a lot for watching this video, and see you in the next one.